investment. Just have to ask for one commitment. And that's the best thing.
Very big thank you, Amuzie of Kingsports live on the show. Once again, big congratulations. You scored your first goal for your football club over the weekend out there in Portugal. Many thanks once again for talking to us live on the show all the way from Portugal. I said many thanks for talking to us live on Stanley. That was Stanley talking to us. Let's take a look at the Nigeria Professional Football League at this point in time, and then we'll start with NFM Football Club. Last week Friday was another exciting time out in the Nigeria Professional Football League, and then this time around they had the better of Wicked Taurus Football Club of Bauchi 1-0. It ended and then Ode made the difference FM Football Club. Cut to Super Sport. Let's see the highlights. To the crisis rocking Nigerian footballer, let them listen to him, and then probably this is another twist to the crisis rocking Nigerian football. And it says the Federation of International Football Associations, FIFA, did not recognize the Amadou Melvin Pinnick board. Mm-hmm. And then this could be shocking, but let's listen to Chris Guam.
Our peer, yes, we went to 2014. Went on two reasons. One was the later, and the second one was the later. And we started as a, and I remember very well because I was in that arbitration sitting. Musa Amadou was there on behalf of the other side. The chairman of the panel asked FIFA lawyer one question: why did you send that letter to Amadou Pinnick? Because our lawyer emphasized on it to indict them, because FIFA had that power to do that. And the lawyer said repeatedly that Sepp Blatter gave that letter on his personal capacity as Sepp Blatter, not as FIFA president. Remember, after all the presentation, the argument, the witnesses, the whatever, when the lawyers were to come for their addresses, I remember the chairman said something. The two lawyers stood addressing only on Article 17. That is, does FIFA have the right? And it's in their words. And I remember the chairman still asked the head of legal department of FIFA there, why didn't you go for a re-election? He said he doesn't know. I'm saying it before the press and before God that FIFA denied recognizing Amadou Pinnick before the CAS.
Well, another twist to the drama of crisis rocking Nigerian football. And indeed, a lot coming from Ambassador Chris Giwa.
It's not
a lot in this to come.
Yeah, it's not, but I think it's worth laughing at, because sometimes some of these guys who are politicians, you know, they tend to, you know, interpret things to suit whatever motives they have. Now, me and we all saw the letter that purportedly came from, you know, FIFA recognizing, you know, the Amajile election.
And what it was saying, what is said
now,
there was that
that letter came from Sepp Blatter.
On a personal
capacity. And I ask, Sepp Blatter at the time, Amajile. How does a letter come on a personal basis? I don't understand.
Well, I think what also looking at the other side of the coin, saying that an executive, well, indeed, it's Manchester City winning by as much as 3-0. But then let's take you all the way to Germany, where we have Omar Katuba live on the line. And interestingly, Luis Figo, indeed, is also, you know, having some form of chat, you know, with a journalist out there in Germany. Omar, good afternoon to you.
In any case, I don't think that that assures you that you can win the trophies. That makes you, of course, much more stronger. Anyway, I think we have the chance this year to be in the final and see what happens.
Do you think...
Sorry, that was the last question.
Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome.
Luis Figo having a Giorgio out there ahead of the big award tonight. Omar, can you give us more details? We also understand that Figo has been talking about the UEFA Champions League games that indeed were played last week. Hello, Omar, can you hear me? Hello, Omar?
Me, I can hear you. As you can see, that was from Figo talking about the Champions League, Manchester City, their chances of winning the tournament. And then this is happening right here at the Laureus World Sports Award. I have Figo, I have Capello, I have Marcel Desailly, I have Cafu, some of the biggest names in world football. It's been very hectic, I must be honest. Everyone struggling to get an interview. I promise that we can get you visuals to give to our viewers from the on the show, maybe from tomorrow.
The awards, we expect them the best of them sportsmen in town, the likes of Usain Bolt and also sportsmen, you know, from motorsports, tennis, athletics and the likes. Apart from Figo, who have you seen ahead of the awards tonight?
Of course, in the next 30 minutes, we're going to have Lewis Hamilton, one of the best Formula One stars, talking with the media. And of course, right here, you have Novak Djokovic, who will be attending the gala as at 7 p.m. And of course, other superstars from around the world. Curtis Freeman is here. Of course, Oliver Bierhoff, Yogi Löw, the coach of the German national team, and other stars from the world of sport. It's the full house. Some are still on their way to this place. And me, like I said, we're going to bring visuals, exclusive pictures on Galaxy TV.
Very big thank you, Omar Akatuba. I know you will be on the red carpet tonight. That's Omar Akatuba, and indeed Luis Figo talking about the UEFA Champions League and all other happenings, the cream de la cream in the world of sports.
It's a great one, and it's always a pleasure when you see great sportsmen who have distinguished themselves like that, talking about the sport that they love affectionately.
Well, I must say very big thank you for coming around, Adams. I'm calling Udeme. Time, not our friend. Tomorrow will be another time in the exciting world of sports. Till then, have a splendid and sporting day.